Hey everybody, Tim here with today's review of James Bond, movie number 7, Diamonds Are Forever. So this is the triumphant first return of Sean Connery. He makes another return later, and it's again his final movie after a 4-year break. And to be honest with you, Sean Connery is so good. Like, he's such a great actor. He's such a good James Bond. I really did like George Lazenby, and I would have loved to see him continue to do other movies, but Connery has that weird thing where since he left and then we got somebody else and then he comes back and you just appreciate him even more, which, I mean, I've hated some of his movies as well. Like, I don't think he has, like, all of the Sean Connery Bond movies are the greatest. He does have some kind of bad ones in there, but it's kind of nice to see him come back, and I do think this is one of the better ones. Out of the ones that he's done, I feel like this is actually my second favorite out of his movies, the first being Goldfinger and then this one, which I'm actually keeping track of, like, ranking all of the movies, and I can throw that out there after I'm done with all of them. It's also interesting, so this is his, we're like I said, this is the 7th movie, so we're about a quarter of the way through the franchise at this point, so that's kind of cool. Now, the movies don't really have a lot of continuity between them. There's a little bit here and there, but not a lot. And so, for example, this one, they don't make a lot of, they don't reference Tracy at all, that the fact the last movie, James Bond got married and then Blofeld killed his wife. Like, they don't reference that at all, but they kind of do, where in the very beginning, the opening scene of this movie is Bond looking for Blofeld, and he is like on a mission, and it's a lot of really great scenes where, like, he's at the card table and the guy's like, hit me, and then just Bond decks him out of nowhere, and he's flirting with a girl, and then he, like, rips her bikini top off and, like, strangles her with it, and he's like, where's Blofeld? And it's some really intense scenes watching him, like, interrogate all of these people. When he finally does get to Blofeld, it's yet another actor, which, whatever, it is what it is, and he talks about, like, how there's plastic surgery, and he's like, he's not necessarily cloning, but there's multiple Blofelds, and how he does finally kill this one. And it's kind of, like I said, it's the whole opening scene is so well done, and it's so intense, where he, like, puts him in, like, that mud pit and, like, turns up the temperature so it starts boiling, and he's like, welcome to hell, Blofeld. And it's like, oh, it's intense. So in the last movie, in the very beginning, George Lazenby did kind of have a shout out where he's like, this never happened to the other fellow. And the same thing kind of happens in this one when Sean Connery returns and M is like, oh, you've been on a holiday, which is again kind of referencing how there could be multiple people all going by the name 007, which is kind of cool. I like that. This movie introduces some very interesting henchmen, Mr. Wint and Mr. Kidd. I really like them, and they're a little intense, like, just of how flat they are and how, like, they don't have a lot of emotion and stuff like that. And supposedly there's, like, the theory that they're lovers together, because, like, in the scene where they're introduced and, like, they just drop the scorpion down the guy's shirt and then they blow up the helicopter and then they walk through the desert holding hands. They're very intense characters, and I actually really liked them a lot. I thought they were pretty good for henchmen. We see Miss Moneypenny return for a very short scene. It was a little sad, but I guess there was a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes where Lois Maxwell was asking for more money. We see Q, which is always great to see, Llewellyn, and it's kind of a nice scene where, like, Bond is peeling off the fake fingerprints and stuff like that, because Bond goes by a lot of different aliases in this movie. He pretends to be a lot of different people. Wint and Kid also have the line where, oh, she seems very really attractive for a lady. So that kind of goes back with they might be lovers together. We see Felix again in this movie, who, again, this is the 4th actor to play Felix. It's a different actor every single time. And I think this is the first time we've seen him since, like, Thunderball. Like, I feel like it's been a while since we've seen him. So that was kind of cool. I liked when we meet Plenty O'Toole and Sean Connery's like, oh, were you named after your father? Like, that kind of made me laugh, just kind of continuing the sexual references and stuff like that. The car chase was, like, so bad, it was really good, where they're, like, going through Vegas and, like, he, like, leans in the car and they drive on 2 wheels through the alleyway. Like, that was a little much for this movie. And I was like, oh, that's so bad. Like, it really made me laugh throughout it. We see two more Blofelds, because of course Blofeld's still alive. And so the interesting thing about this movie and Blofeld is, of course, he gets away at the end. And so there was a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes with like the rights for James Bond and who created what and all this other stuff. And so this is actually like the first, like, we don't really see Blofeld or Spectre again for like 44 years until the last movie that just came out, Spectre, where they, Eon Productions, finally kind of got the rights to have Blofeld come back. I mean, there is a short little shout out to the character in the movie, like For Your Eyes Only, which is 10 years after this movie came out. And then in Never Say Never, which is an unofficial, not Eon Productions movie, there's Blofeld. But as far as the Eon movies, like, this is it. We're finally out of that Blofeld connection. And some people have said, like, these first seven movies are so heavy with that character and with Spectre and everything, that it was good. Like, it was an okay move to move away from that character. And so I agree. So and to be honest with you, like, I didn't really care for Blofeld in this movie or the last one. Even like Donald Pleasant's character, where he's like petting the cat like really hard and stuff, like, I was kind of like, I always liked him more when we didn't see him. I always thought less was more. And so, and I'm okay with like moving away and going in a new direction after this movie. I really like the fight sequence where just Bond gets his ass kicked by Bumpy and Thamber. Bambi and Thumper. Mix that up. So Bambi and Thumper just kick his ass. It was a great scene. We see Q playing the slot machines, and that was kind of fun, where he has the ring and it just keeps giving him all the money. Who wouldn't want that? Blofeld and Drag was a little bit much for me when he's trying to escape. Like, as soon as they started going that direction, I was like, are they really? And sure enough, they did. But I don't know, it was kind of a cool shout out. And I forgot to mention, the actor that plays Blofeld in this movie was the guy who plays the curator in the Rocky Horror Picture Show, the guy that does, like, it's the time warp and stuff. So that was kind of cool. So he went from being in Rocky Horror to being in this movie, where he wears women's clothes as well, for that one little scene. I liked the scene where where Bond is switching the tapes, and then he like sticks it, or he has to go back to Tiffany to give it to her, and he just calls her a bitch and like shoves it down her like bikini. But I mean, that was kind of a funny scene, and then walks away. There was the crane scene. We finally see Wint and Kid again in the final scene, like where it was kind of a hardcore scene where they're like delivering the food, and he like lights one of them on fire, and like, yeah, it was a hard like kind of scene to watch the henchmen go out on. And then that was kind of it. Like, it was a really good movie. I really enjoyed this one a lot. Like I said, so far out of the first seven, I would say this is probably my second favorite. I thought like Sean Connery did a great job, and it was really great to see him again. And then, of course, he said that he would never play James Bond again, which is why in the next comeback movie, it's Never Say Never Again. So overall, I really enjoyed this one. I thought it had some great car chases. I really liked Tiffany. I thought she was a great female companion to Bond. The henchmen were great. Blofeld was kind of hit and miss. Like I said, I'm kind of glad that we're done with him. But he is kind of a fun character to kind of watch the way he develops and how he creates this cloning plastic surgery technique to kind of live throughout other people, so nobody really knows who's who. So that was kind of cool. Overall, yeah, I say this is a really good Bond movie. For those who have seen this one, what did you think? What did you think about Sean Connery's return? What did you think about O'Toole and Plenty O'Toole? And what did you think about Tiffany? What did you think about Blofeld and more or less his final movie for quite a while, long time? What did you think about Wint and Kid? Go ahead, let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys for everything. And I will see you guys next time for Roger Moore's debut movie, Live and Let Die.